welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to take you on a little tour of Dubai because we are going villa viewing today. We have got, I think, four or five properties that we want to go and see. And today is Saturday. It is May the 30th. So I've been up early this morning. I've ploughed through loads of check-ins with my clients. I've done my normal Saturday routine. I've checked myself in. Darren's done his check-in. And it's now just coming up to 1 p.m. So we're going to head out. We're going to view some properties. And I will catch up with you guys in the next clip.
This is what our lives have become. So yes, restrictions have been lifted in Dubai. We can move around freely, but we have to wear these delightful things. How do we match today?
I got dressed first.
We're even wearing matching Converse.
I'm not matching, it's purple and white.
Shut up.
What's the purpose of today, babe? You set these viewings up, what are we doing?
So today we're just kind of going to look at a couple of different villas in different areas, and so we're going to look in like Mira, Ream, Town Square, just get an idea which ones we prefer, and kind of decide on the area we want to move to, and then in a week or two we'll go back to the ones we prefer and select a villa, because there's like three or four bedroom options, some five bedrooms, so we'll see.
Yes, basically Darren told me last night before we were going to bed, oh, I've booked some viewings, we're going to go and see some villas. So that's what we're doing today. He's organised all of this, so fingers crossed we've got some nice ones to go and look at. Our lease is up for our rent on our apartment in August, so we've got some time, but he thought it might be quite nice to go and look at some places today.
Number 96. Yeah. Darren.
Okay, so this is property number one. This is a three-bedroom townhouse. It's actually, I think it's semi-detached. So the main door is here, but obviously we can't go in that, it's locked. But the side door takes you into the garden, or should I say the side gate. And this is the garden, which I kind of like because it's not overlooked. The walls are high enough for the dog, which is always a good thing. And actually, this gate goes out onto like a residence pathway, so you can't see out into like a road or anything like that. And then you come in here. This will be your main living space, kitchen, living area. It's pretty big actually. And then this kind of sliding door, separate room, which could be my office, it could be the dining room. You could actually put a dining room table and chairs, it'd be nice for entertaining, and possibly have the sofa and stuff here. And then you've got downstairs bathroom, storage under the stairs. And then if you don't know, in Dubai, what everybody has downstairs is like an extra room, which is what you call the maid's room. So it's a little box room, where if you had a live-in maid, they would stay here. And then there's an extra bathroom. So already we've got two bathrooms downstairs, but I think I'd probably make the maid's room into my office. And then that's obviously the front door that I showed you. So upstairs. Okay, straight into the first door. We go into the master bedroom. Pretty decent size. You've got a large window here, out into a shared balcony with the other bedroom. Storage. Master bathroom, two sinks, love that. And then even more storage here, and a little dressing room area. Okay. And then this is probably the smallest of the guest rooms, but still has some storage over there. Lots of light out onto the street. As you can see from here, all the villas look a similar sort of size. Okay, and then into the next big bedroom, which again has the sharing balcony
with the master bedroom. Again, a pretty decent size. You'd get a double bed in here. And then you've got wardrobe space. And then these two rooms, this one and this one, which are this bathroom. So you have four bathrooms in one house, which is crazy. But yeah, on to the next one.
Right, oh, property number one. Immediate response out of 10, babe.
The actual villa itself, 7.
Yeah.
And the area, 7 or 8.
Okay. So, not wowed, but got potential.
Yeah, definitely. I like the size of like the actual area, like the garden size, the way the garden's designed. It's probably the only thing I don't like probably is the way the kitchen leads into the living room.
Mm.
But there is other, I've looked, there is other designs available.
In this exact complex?
This is Hyatt, there's Noor, and there is Safi. And Safi are slightly bigger.
Darren knows his stuff, he's been doing his research. So that's villa number one, 7 out of 10. Do you know what, I'd give it a 6 or a 7 out of 10. But then that's just me being really fussy. I want to be wowed by something before I think about moving. Because our apartment is mega. Yeah.
It's hard though when you go in and it's like dirty and there's nothing in there.
That's very true.
You know, if you put a couch in there and you can see like the letter, it's a bit different.
This is very true. Okay, on to the next one. We're in Mira, and that's just a little way along from Town Square where we were previously, literally about 4 kilometers along the road. And we've just looked at a 3-bedroom, but we love the finish of it. We like the area, but we want bigger living space. So they're gonna take us now, the estate agents, to a 4-bed, which has a bigger living area downstairs, hopefully a bigger bedroom. Yeah, so I'll video that one instead of this one. Much bigger living space. It doesn't have that separate like dining room, but I quite like open plan. And then you've got like the door to the garage. You've got the maid's room again, which could be the study. Okay, 2 secs. Really large reception landing area, which brings a lot of light in here. And then this is the master bedroom, which is a lot bigger. But my issue here is storage. Like, we have a walk-in wardrobe in our apartment, and if that's the storage for the master, I don't know. Bathroom's nice, really nice. And then we were just chatting to the guys here, and whereas this is like a quite nice view now, there's gonna be a huge development going on here. And I don't know if you guys can see, but those like buses and stuff, that's all like the worker vehicles. So makes me think there's gonna be a lot of building work going on if we were to live here. And then you've got another bedroom here and another bedroom in here, and they share this bathroom, but there are no doors into the bathroom, whereas the other ones have got like a I don't know what you call it, like a top and tail. Oh, not top and tail, I can't remember what it's called, but where you have like 2 bathrooms that are joined, or 1 bathroom that's joined by 2 bedrooms. Now going to the 3rd property, wait, actually 4th, because we saw the 3-bed, we've seen the 4-bed, he's now taking us to an upgraded version of this other 4-bed that might have more living space. We're gonna have a look now, but yeah, it's really hot. It's like nearly 2 o'clock and it's definitely 40 something degrees, sweating like crazy. So this is the 4th property and it's mega. This one is 4 bedrooms upstairs, which I'll show you. It's got another study downstairs and a maid's room too. So it's pretty much a 5-bedroom. What I like about it is it's a mega garden, which I'll show you in a second. But I like this entrance area here, the main door. You come straight in and you've got a huge room here that leads out into the garden patio doors. Downstairs bathroom.
Grand Prix to Costa. So our family, there's a smaller one than this, which you could just have everyone from Costa as well.
Huge kitchen. Goes out into the garage, and then this would be my office with an extra bathroom. Okay, this room here is just one of the spare rooms. Looks out onto the street. It's beautiful. This whole area, Mira, is pretty beautiful, and it's finished. So all of these places are finished really nicely. Spare bathroom. I'm dying. Okay, that's just spare bedroom number one. Then from here, you then turn left and you come into the master bedroom. It's the master bedroom that overlooks the mega garden. Huge master bedroom. No storage, but a walk-in wardrobe, literally a walk-in wardrobe. I'm in it, it's massive. Okay, and then gorgeous bathroom with a shower and a bath. It's been a long time since I've had a bubble bath, and then separate toilet, which is in there. So I like this, and two sinks. And then come back to the top of the stairs again. We've got the other room over here. So you've got three bedrooms upstairs, one sharing bathroom here, and, oh God, no, you've got one, two, three, four bedrooms, one sharing bathroom, one ensuite in there, and another ensuite in there. Okay, so we're back in the car now on our way home. I think that's enough viewing for today. We've seen four, five properties. Majority of them were in a place called Mira. And we've seen a whole range of three bedroom, four bedroom, and then a four bedroom mega one, which was the last one that I just showed you. And I think we're pretty sold on that one. We really like that one. So we're gonna call it a day. It's coming up to 3 o'clock. We're gonna head home, get something to eat. I'm gonna finish off a bit of work. I'm gonna finish off with my client check-ins. We're gonna chill for the afternoon, have a talk about what we saw, what we liked, and yeah, we'll keep you guys updated. But yeah, we really, 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 really like that one. Don't we, babe? And this song comes on. You just know it's a sign.
Just a touch, baby. I look up since it is cold and empty. No one's around to judge me. I can see clearly when you're gone. Oh, oh,
okay, so it's just coming up to 6:15. We've finished all our work. We're home now, obviously, from all the viewings of the villas. It's quite an ordeal in this heat, I can tell you. But the sun is just setting. We're gonna take the dog out for a walk, and then we're gonna sit down and we're going to have our free meal tonight. And as always, Darren's in charge. He's on delivery right now as we speak, ordering in something delicious for us to eat. So I will show you that later. But right now, it's time for dog walk.
Loki. Stop sniffing Stitch. He doesn't like it. Go on, Stitch. Bop him in the head. Go on, get him. You're a scaredy cat. Yeah, you're gonna come sit by me for protection. From a cat. Lokes, seriously. Stitch. Yeah, you're the boss cat. Are we ready to go for walkies?
Loki, sit down.
Sit down.
Sit for daddy.
Sit down. No, no, come on. Sit. Good boy.
Good boy. You ready? Let's go. What do we have here? So we've got two Pokeballs from Sushi Counter.
because I kind of wanted sushi, kind of wanted a poke bowl. And then we've lived in Dubai for nearly almost 4 years now. And we've never had Panda Express. And Darren was like, I kind of fancy Chinese. Should we get some Chinese? So I was like, okay, let's try it. And we managed to make it home before sunset, which is nice. So this is a pretty hefty poke bowl. Can't go wrong with a bit of sushi and rice. And then this is the first time trying Panda Express, and Darren just informed me they got it wrong because he ordered one rice and one noodles, and we ended up with two noodles. But we've got some kung pao prawns, I think. No, yes. And then some chicken. It's a small noodles. That's massive. That fills my whole plate. And then this is their famous orange chicken, which we've never tried. I don't know what's so good about it, but let's see. That's massive. I can't get up how freaking huge that is. Darren just ate this chili and almost died. Noodles are good. They're pretty stodgy. I like this orange chicken. It's very nice. Not bad. This is what I'm talking about. Come on, who doesn't love a poke bowl? After all that greasy Chinese food, I think actually this is gonna be so delicious. Sweatpants are on. Ready to chill on that sofa. But hardest job of the whole Saturday is finding something to watch on Netflix. Now, we're massive fans of like seasons and stuff, and we watch BritBox and love a British drama and love like crime thrillers. But on a Saturday, I'm like, come on, man, we need to find a good movie. And Darren always picks a movie and it's rubbish. And then I pick a movie and it's pretty pants. So fingers crossed for a good movie and chill. Loki has got his bone. Saturday cheat meal all round for everybody. And Stitchy. Oh, Stitchy's there. Stitchy's busy looking out the window at Fluff. Isn't that right? Look at the state of this chair. Look what he's done to this chair.